MGM guys. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. We're going off to a client job site. I'm here at Kent's house. Say what's up to him.
Yo.
We got Kent here, he's my head of client success. What we're doing today is we are visiting one of our clients, so I want to take you guys along with it so you can see the process behind the scenes of us capturing content, heading to the client job sites, how we get drone footage or the walk around videos raw that we end up turning into ads. I don't know how much I'm gonna document because I'm still working on my storytelling and this is kind of my first go at this style of video, but stay tuned. I'm gonna take you through and show you as much as I can throughout the day. So stay posted. Now, before this video moves forward any further, I wanted to preface it because this was the first time that I was filming with this camera. I didn't know how to adjust a lot of the lighting settings. So in the car, just because I have tint, we're gonna appear very dark and underexposed, but I wanted to include some of the clips just because it gives context as for where we ended up going. Now, the second thing is that we combined 2 days of filming into one video pretty much just because I wasn't able to edit this very quickly and we did the visits back to back. So what you're about to see is from day one. And no, I didn't document this very well. And if this does end up coming out, I'm going to edit this anyway. I don't know whether I'm going to end up posting it, but if this does come out, this is just kind of context behind the scenes of going to a client visit. And as you'll probably see later in the video, you'll realize that a lot of these things don't end up going to plan, whether it's just due to logistics or things out of your control. And that's something to keep in mind. And that's something that we have kept in mind. And it is just is what it is. And you have to roll with the punches. So without further ado, this is going to be day one. I'm going to continue to kind of butt in here and talk to give you more context as I continue to edit, as well as show the clips that we ended up taking, just because I don't know if I did a good job transitioning that. So here's us in the car on day one.
All right, here we are on the way to Rumson.
On the way to Rumson, just had to gas up and grab a quick monster caffeine break. Kent, you wanna tell them where we're heading to and what we're gonna do?
So we're going to a pool builder client's house in Rumson, New Jersey, right on the water. We're going to film some drone videos, film some raw B-roll content, film some walk around pool videos, talk to the pool builder owner, have him film some content, point out some key features about the property and the project, and we'll go from there.
Yeah, I think it'll be super exciting because it'll be a behind the scenes look. We're gonna get a client interview as well. And if we can, if the homeowner is home, then we'll also get. If we can, then we will also interview the homeowner just so that they have it as content on their feed as well. Because just like us and how we like to get social proof and testimonials, it's pretty important for you guys to be getting social proof and testimonials for your own clients as well, so that there's trust up front. When people go and look at your Facebook page, they see video reviews, ratings, 5-star ratings. That plus Google obviously helps a ton. And overall, the entire premise of grabbing this content is to have more social proof, right? Like I say in all of my videos, oh man, that's a cop. Like I said, the whole premise of grabbing videos and grabbing more content is always just to have social proof. And the more social proof you have on your profile for people to scroll and you know, in the depths of the nighttime when they're lying in bed before they make a decision to call you in the morning, the better it is. So whatever content you can grab, we're gonna show you. We're doing it on a camera. I've just bought this camera and I have a couple more camera setups, but we're also gonna film a ton of content on our iPhones as well, just to demonstrate that you don't need any fancy setup to do this. You don't need to buy any fancy cameras, and you certainly don't need to hire a film crew or a videographer to just get started. Obviously, that'd be nice if you wanna have like a proper documentation on your profile of completed projects, but in process and for day to day and to post on your story for people to reference, you really don't need that much. So we have about another hour drive ahead of us, so 57 minutes. So we're going to go up and we'll see you once we're there. So we're here at the homeowner's house. We're finally here in Rumson, New Jersey. This is the house right here. Right now we're unpacking the bags, getting the cameras out. It's really hot. It's like damn near 100 degrees. We're in jeans, long pants. It's cooked. But right here are the camera configurations. We got the DJI Osmo that I'm gonna take. And then Kent's got the drone in hand that he's gonna fly. So I'll take you guys to walk around the pool deck in just a second. And then now we have the drone going up, DJI drone. And so let's head over to the pool, take a look at that. Pardon me, I'm sweating my ass off already. And let's show you what we are going to do in order to get this content out. All right, take a look at this pool. So I'm gonna overlay some B-roll of what I'm about to take for you guys to take a look. Right now, I believe it's a 20 by 40. Could be wrong, I don't have the dimensions nor was I told how big the actual pool is. But we have a waterfall feature, coping, pavers, and a hot tub. So now this is a little bit older, but it's still a higher end project and it still looks very, very nice and will serve us well to take some content. It's also really cool too, because if you could see behind me, we're right on an inlet, I believe that's what it's called, where it's a body of water. These guys have boats and jet skis and it just takes them straight out to the ocean. So it's pretty cool. So what we're gonna do right now is I'm gonna set this camera up and then I'm going to take some content on both my iPhone as well as the DJI Osmo and get some 4K B-roll, get some walk around videos, and I'll play them for you right now. Yeah, I'm up. Now they want me cause I'm on the mud. Didn't help me when I was that stuck. Now I'm moving, they talking, I'm backing it up. Tell my old girl I don't need her. I'm the real black Justin Bieber. She won't come down, no Selena. Got too close, gotta leave her. So we're in the car now, we finished up filming. Back, we're driving to get something to eat real quick. And what did we just do?
So we just filmed a nice house in Rumson right on the water. We did some drone footage over top, zooming in, zooming out, panning across the pool. Took some nice B-roll footage, took some nice 4K raw format iPhone walk around style videos that really showcase the, I don't know what to call it, the nature of the pool.
Yeah, and we wanted to do this as well. Obviously, we're in person and we continue to evolve. I want to, by all means, make it known we're not professional videographers. I don't claim to be, but the reason that we want to do this and that we do this for our clients is just to demonstrate how easy it is to actually get the content that we would need to turn into creatives without having to hire a content team, right? So being able to do it yourself is kind of the main thing, especially since you guys are the ones that are on job sites, and like the accessibility to take a video or photo is just, you're right there. So like, come on, do it.
I mean, I'll chime in right here. You know, the more hands that are in the pot, the harder it is to operationally execute all the stuff that you want to do. If you're dependent on someone else coming out and filming the content you need for however much you want to pay them, you can easily do the same thing right here. You got a $300 drone, you don't even need a drone. Take your regular iPhone camera, film it in 4K, 60 FPS, walk around really nice and slow, and that's all you need.
Yeah, and normally you would see interviews where we talk to the client as well as the homeowner, but neither of them today wanted to be on camera, which we'll obviously respect because we like to do talking head segments. Obviously, we're gonna be posting this on behalf of the company page, but you know, some business owners don't want to, but if you have the opportunity to, I would highly encourage you film some talking head segments. At least having it on your profiles or your website, introducing who you are, what you guys do, what you guys specialize in, so that people can put a face to the name, so that they know who they're gonna be talking to or who they're gonna be dealing with before you enter their homes. Because these days, video format, you guys are watching this right now, I mean, it builds a lot of trust, and almost being able to speak on camera, and I've made a whole separate video about this, and be able to convey what you guys do as a business is so, so important. And to the agency owners that are watching this right now, if you're not doing this for your own clients, or you know, I'm sure wherever you're located, granted if you're in Europe or Asia and you're dealing with US clients, it's a little bit different. But if you are based in the States and you have clients in the States, you're inevitably gonna have someone who is relatively local to you, and if you are not actually going out and getting content, shaking hands with them, meeting them, and filming content for them to actually use as creatives, you're gonna lose, man. You're gonna lose, especially in this day and age, because we're not a content agency and we don't claim to be, but we're kind of pivoting towards it because we just know that's what's necessary. And that's how you win in today's age. It doesn't matter what business you're in, you need content. Local businesses now more than ever need content. And so if you're not partaking in it and you're not actually getting the adequate amount of content to convey your brand to the outside world online and build a social presence, you're gonna lose. So I had to get that off my chest. We're gonna film a separate video kind of talking about how we operate on the back end. It'll be a separate video on the channel that you guys can reference. But since we're sitting in traffic, let's go ahead and film it. All right, so just to butt in again real quick, apologies once more because the clip that we just played is extremely, extremely black. But right here are the iPhone clips that I took. So I'm gonna go ahead and play them raw. I know that previous B-roll I edited, but this is gonna be completely raw, completely silent. So we'll go ahead and play those right now. All right, so I thought it'd be better to film a loom and describe what I'm doing in each clip rather than just sending it to you in silence. So the first one is a walk around of the feature, specifically the waterfall and the hot tub, and really emphasizing on that. Then the next one is specifically in the waterfall itself, having a down to up motion so that we can use it as a clip in an ad. And then the third one is a kind of right to left pan of the entire pool. So you just want to take a bunch of short clips just like this. And then, as you can see, nothing is more than 10 seconds long, except for the full walk around once I get to that. And it's for the most part just showing the pool, right? And so I varied between 0.5 zoom and regular zoom for this while I walked around the project. But I really just wanted to capture all of the angles just to make sure that we're really able to encompass what this looks like. And it's always better to capture more footage than less, because you can not include things and edit things out post-production, but you can't, once we leave the project, it's done, right? So I always try to over-capture or sometimes even double-capture certain clips just to make sure it's good enough to be used in the videos. So I've been doing left to right pans, down to up, up to down, things like that, just so that we have a full picture of, you know, what the project looks like. And although it's not in here, a 40-second-ish video was taken of walking around the project. So from starting at that waterfall feature in the hot tub, going around the entire pool with the phone pointing at the pool directly. And I think all of these, I don't know what this is. I'm not sure why this is here. Yeah, these are probably an accident. But point in case, these were all shot on the iPhone vertically. These are all perfect things to post not only on your story, but also in your feed. So it just goes to show, think of it, or remember this, left to right, right to left, up to down, essentially like a game controller, right? You wanna just have, you always wanna have movement. So left to right, right to left, up to down, down to up, and capture all angles and specific features of your project. And in this case specifically, it had a cool waterfall feature, right? As well as this feature in the hot tub, this jet in the hot tub, which are two of the biggest features that I focused on, and you should do the same. So back to the video. And as you can probably notice, they're really, really simple. So it's literally just 20, 30 seconds walking around your project with your phone in your hand, making sure that you're keeping it relatively smooth so that you're not like shaking. And for the most part, you don't need to color grade anything. You don't need to do anything fancy. You can literally just take the raw content that came out of your phone and post it on your feed or post it as a story on your Instagram or Facebook. And by just doing that, nothing fancy, no posts, nothing wild, no captions, no edits. By just starting to just force yourself to put up that video or put up that story is going to start to help monumentally. And it's gonna be tough initially because you're not gonna see instant gratification or instant results. But over time, the people that will see it and the people that will talk to you about it, it's going to grow and it's going to be significantly impactful on the way that you actually build trust with your customers. So that pretty much wrapped up the first day. The rest of the clips that we took were rather insignificant because it was just driving home. And so I'm gonna talk a little bit about day two, which is when we went to another part of Jersey to capture the videos, and I'm gonna play the in-car clips now. So now we're in the car here with Kent. This is our second visit in less than a week. I haven't even gotten to edit the first video yet. We just had to come to do this because the rest of the week it's gonna be raining. So we're on our way again to Jersey Shore.
Yeah.
Or what's it called?
We're going to Spring Lake.
Spring Lake, okay. This project, I don't know how it's gonna be. I don't think it's gonna be a super high-end project, but it's still worthwhile to bring you guys along and show you the process in the back end and still take content for it, because not every project's gonna be super high-end. And if you are someone who resonates with the homeowner demographic and they're going to be getting a, you know, maybe a fiberglass pool, like a $70,000 to $90,000 project, then this is good to see and view, just because there are a lot of you guys, actually probably a majority of you guys, are going to be serving that demographic, because there are just simply more of those homeowners than there are like the super, super high-end wealthy projects. So it's gonna be worthwhile to take a look at how we document this and how we put it up on behalf of this client and sort of the results that it generates from that, just because this is gonna be a lot more relatable to like 99% of your homeowners and probably 99% of you.
That's well put. Yeah, we're just doing exactly what we said we would do. You know, the first few times you go out and do this stuff yourself as well, it's not going to be the best, but if you practice and keep doing it, you refine the process and then you eventually start pumping out content. Mm-hmm. Look, they got an outdoor kitchen.
All right, we made it to the client job site. This is a lot nicer than I thought it was going to be, so take a look.
Outdoor kitchen, dining area, looks like speakers.
Looks like someone inside. There's a pool right here. Huge backyard. They've got a little shed as well. Outdoor kitchen, yeah. Pretty sick. So we're gonna take some videos of the pool, of the patio, like this entire project we're gonna make content out of. I think we'll probably film some ads for myself too here, just because it's a nice project to do. So surprisingly nice, actually. I didn't expect it. On Google Maps it didn't look this nice, but this looks like it was completely torn down and redone recently. So we're gonna get the drone up and I'll shoot some videos on the DJI Osmo as well as my iPhone, so that you guys know how to replicate it if you have a project remotely similar to this. Okay, so I'm going to end the video here. I know it's rather abrupt, but what ended up happening in that last clip, as you saw, we did end up capturing content, photos, videos. We even actually threw up the drone and were able to capture a lot of what the project entailed, as well as other projects within the neighborhood and see the neighborhood. It was super, super nice, but I'm not going to actually end up playing or releasing any of them, just because what ended up happening was, after we recorded a lot of the content, the homeowner actually came out and didn't know that we were gonna be there. There was, I suppose, a miscommunication on the end of my client as well as them, but they didn't know we were gonna be there. They didn't want us to capture any of the content, and so as a result, we're not going to use any of it out of respect, and I don't think it's legal if they didn't give us consent. So moreover, you saw snippets of what that project looked like. It had a really nice outdoor kitchen, a patio, and a really nice pool. It was a lot nicer than we anticipated, but unfortunately it got cut really short just because we didn't have consent to use the footage from the homeowner because of a miscommunication issue. What can we learn from that? I don't really know, other than the fact that we just have to roll with the punches and for you guys to just see and understand that these things happen. And so if you've watched this far into the video all the way to the end and you have seen kind of both days of us filming, then I appreciate it. And if you think or like this style of content, long form, as well as the documentation style, then leave a comment below. I know I didn't do a great job at it, because I obviously have to butt in so many times and understand, explain what's going on here. But hopefully in the next few visits, I capture the content with the correct lighting that I understand how to do now, as well as being able to storyboard and document the process a little bit better and explain what's going on in the moment so that we can have a little bit more of a cohesive storyline rather than me having to butt in like this every single time. So without further ado, that's gonna be the end of this video. I appreciate you watching and I'll see you in the next one.